Hey guys, welcome to another ServerMiner plugin tutorial. I'm your host LTJim007 and today it's on Kit PvP. Now most of you will probably have heard of a similar plugin which allows you to fight people using different kits, but this is a really fantastic plugin that's easy to set up and has some cool features. So if we go ahead and right click the sign to join, you will see that there is a few things here. There's the challenge item, so you can challenge a particular person. There are the kits, and in here you can see all of the awesome kits. So there's Archer, Hunter, Police, Tank, Bomber, Potter, etc. And they all have different abilities, which is cool, and how many coins you have. So normal people would have to buy them. And then obviously you have the exit button. So let's go ahead and rejoin, and you can see there are two different types of queues. There is the 1v1 queue and the FFA queue. So let's go ahead and teleport back to the lobby from the arena, and that will take a few seconds by clicking this item. So if we do /kit PvP help, you will see all of the commands and you can do a range of things. So first of all, we are going to do /kit PvP set lobby, and then we're going to do /kit PvP set hollow. You can also do this by doing /kit PvP setup, and then you can set them in here, and you can also look at the settings and look at the arenas that already exist in here as well. So let's go ahead and create our own arena now. If we do /kit PvP 1v1 create arena, hit enter, it will give us an arena ID and we'll need that for saving. So if we then do /kit PvP 1v1 set spawn and then the number, so spawn 1, then if we go ahead and come over here and repeat the command to spawn 2, and once we've done that, all we need to do is kit PvP 1v1 save arena, and then stick the ID on the end so it knows which arena you're saving. Then we can go ahead and create an FFA arena by doing the same command. Instead of 1v1, it's FFA, and then you type create map followed by the map name and whoever built it. You can add on the end if you want. So once you've done that, it's very straightforward. You set the spawns and then you'll be done. So if you do /kit PvP FFA set spawn and then the map name, so map tut, let's go ahead and repeat the command over here like so, and we have now set both arenas, the FFA one and the 1v1 one. And now we can do a few more things, such as setting the entity. So if we do /kit PvP set entity, if we spell it correctly, that is, and we're going to do the 1v1 entity first so people can join that type of game mode, and then we do the FFA one as well. That's very straightforward. So if you just replace 1v1 with FFA, it will work perfectly. There we go. So we now have lots of skeletons around here that people can use to join different games. Then if we do kit PvP reload, we can reload anything that's in the config files as well. And if we do kit PvP join, we can join the lobby instead of using the sign. But if you want to use the sign, it's very straightforward. You do brackets kit PvP brackets on the top line and join on the second line. Then it will automatically create the sign and you can join. So I've got my other account in the game, and once the countdown has gone down, we can start fighting each other. We're using the Kit Hunter, and if I give him a whack a few times, he will die. It will say I have won the game and I get 10 points. And normal people would be able to use points to buy kits. So if we want to challenge him, we hit him with the sword, and then on his screen, if we flip over to that, you will see a GUI pops up and we can either accept it. It tells us who is giving us the ultimatum, or we can deny it. And there we go. So we've denied the request from LTJim. So that's pretty much how it works in game. You can obviously choose different queues and whatnot, and whether you want FFA or a 1v1. And then if you've changed your mind, you can obviously go back to lobby. So here we are in the SM Picnic control panel. And as you can see, there are a lot of folders and files, but you don't really need to mess around with too much of these. Let's go ahead and go in the config file. And in here, there is loads of things you can do. So you can disable hunger, you can change the amount of soup heals you buy, and you can change the various kits and the contents of each kit as well, which is really cool. So if we scroll down, you can see some of them get lots of mushroom soup, different types of armor, and obviously you can change any of these. And at the bottom, you can change how the sign looks, how the hologram looks, and how the scoreboard looks as well. So if we go into data.yml, there's nothing much in here. This just saves various data and lobby locations, stuff like that. The next file is the kits.yml. So in here, it saves everything to do with the kits, the description of the kit, the price. So when you get all those points, you can spend it on kits, and they give you various things such as, I don't know, potions, ender pearls, all that good stuff. Then if we go into messages, you can change color codes, format codes, and what it says, which is really awesome. So not too much in there. You don't really need to mess around with that at all. And if we go back, the final file is the player data. You don't need to mess around with the folders up there, as that just saves data as well. If you want to download this plugin, there'll be a link in the description down below. If you need a server to host it on, check out serverminer.com for the best and cheapest hosting around. But that's it for me for this week. Subscribe, like, comment, and I'll see you next time.